So at this point, I'm just working on the light side and the shadow side of the peaches, and there isn't a dramatic difference necessarily between the values, but I do want to indicate right at the beginning the shapes of the peaches and the general feeling of light and shadow in the jar. But it's important to note that both the light side and shadow side of these peaches are in the middle value range of our value scale. Now, after working for a little while in the middle value scale, I'm going to go with just a little bit deeper value now and go to some areas where the peaches are turning away from the light and going a little bit deeper in color. Now, before I continue further on the peaches, I'm going to start working on the background and start laying in some of the color of the shadow down there. And I have a bit of a greenish tone mixed, and you can see overall it is darker than what's going on in the jar. And that helps the jar feel a little bit more luminous when I take the shadow a little bit deeper in value. Okay, after painting the cast shadow, I always like to go in with a little bit warmer, darker tone and paint the dark occlusion shadow, and that is where the jar contacts the surface of the table. And usually that's always quite warm. There'll be a little bit of mix of warm and cool going on there because there's the thickness of the glass that you have to consider. But I'm going to first put the dark down, and then I can go back and modify that later on in the painting. Okay, now even with the jar lid, there are some really high contrast elements in the jar, but I want to start again with the midtones so that I can pop out those really high key values later on in the piece, those real bright highlights, and that will give it that metallic quality to it. But you really need to start in the midtones and not go after those really high contrasts right at the beginning, because it's the midtones that are going to hold the whole piece together.